single mother Phyllis Snelson hadn't lived in her Apollo estate home for long before a nighttime home invasion last year.
They got through my daughter's bedroom window. They've smashed it or something and used a screwdriver or whatever to get in.
Her daughter, one of three children, is now too scared to go to the bathroom alone at night.
That's where they kicked my window.
According to Phyllis, someone also tried to burn her home down.
We were called dogs and whatever because we've rang the police. And that's what I said, like, what am I supposed to do? I'm on my own with the kids.
You got one too?
The New South Wales Department of Housing told SBS it had invited Phyllis to discuss her situation, but it found claims of ongoing harassment to be unfounded. Key crime indicators in Dubbo fell after the government pulled down a problem estate on the other side of town in 2006. But since families were moved on, some to the Apollo estate, the arson, drugs and alcohol, truancy and claims of police harassment are now commonplace here too. Max Wiseman is Phyllis's father. He's also worked in the community on both estates.
I remember saying back then to a lot of council workers and officials, but if you don't do something about the area around the Apollo estate and all that, it'll end up being another Gordon estate.
He fears the mistakes of the past have been repeated.
And that was just went on deaf ears, and now here we are this day and age, we've got another Gordon estate.
Much of the crime making up Dubbo's recent high ranking on the New South Wales tables happens here. The police presence is heavy, and local Aboriginal youth say they're a target. Some people, including the mayor, say this estate should be demolished as well. But it's the local MP who's been dealt the job of finding a solution.
We need some game-changing decisions taken now that will not only benefit East Dubbo, but will benefit every community that has these same sorts of social issues.
Troy Grant admits a small minority is causing most of the problems on the estate, but the ex-officer denies the police are too tough. He wants a better mix of social and private housing, not the use of bulldozers. While the action group has drafted a report, the New South Wales government is still deciding which department will act on which recommendation, ideas that they've refused to share with SBS. While people here on the Apollo estate are sick of the crime, they're also tired of their names being dragged through the mud. And they say that the good eggs here on the estate shouldn't be ignored. Lionel Wood grew up on the now demolished Gordon estate and is set to take up a career with the police. He's more than used to reading about trouble in the local paper. Trouble, he says, is overstated.
And we're like, oh, what trouble? You know, what's happening here that we don't know of, you know?
He works with teens and others at the local community centre. It's just received enough government funding to stay open for another year. He says it's an important part of a community which is ready to face its issues head on.
Never seen a true sense of the word community until I've been working here. You know, where everyone knows everyone, not just in the street, but to five streets over, you know what I mean?
There are real problems here, but there's also optimism from some of the people who know it best.